rock steady at King of the Pit TV.
Yes, now bless now. Don't forget, rest now. There's Rocksteady at King of the Pit TV signing in. We're listening to The Doors' self-titled record. This one's entitled Light My Fire. You might know this one. 33 million views on this. Track 6 of 11. Without further ado, let's hear Jim give it his best. Come on. Or at least we should have. But we're getting given a 7-Up advertisement. This is my reaction to this advertisement. It looks refreshing. I'd have wiped the can down potentially beforehand through one means or another. It's a bit wet in it. He's happy. Great pair of teeth on him. 7-Up taste that lifts you up. Let's keep moving. Come on. Not a very big fan of 7-Up, me personally. I think I prefer Sprite.
To say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher.
Was Danzig originally of the Misfits, was he influenced by Jim Morrison by any chance?
Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire.
There's such a strange disconnect of his performance in comparison to the upbeat major tonality and flamboyancy of them keys. You know, there's such a bizarre enigma of sound that the Doors create.
The time to hesitate is through. The time to wallow in the mire. China, we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre.
Some interesting stuff here. So, the album was released in January 1967, and the reaction was huge. By July, Light My Fire had become the number one song in the nation. There will never again be so pure and sweet the two instrumentals that Ray and Robbie did at the break. Perhaps the finest recorded rock and roll studio recordings to have ever been created. Rothchild was a genius. So were Manzarek and Morrison when the latter dropped to his knees in the sand in July of 1965, chanting phrases and singing lines from Moonlight Drive to Manzarek, who agreed they would make millions if they formed a group. Railster says, my question is, how the hell would you come out with a sound and quality of writing like this in 2020? Would it be even considerable? It's incredible. I'm not going to read the rest of his comment. Yeah, there's lots of plenty great artists out here. The only difference is the mainstream and the labels pick them for a reason. Yeah, they push them to the forefront for a reason. All of these historical bands have had to please the right people in order to be historically relevant. I said something I heard at the start of this video, at the start of Breaking Through to the Other Side, in regards to Jim Morrison's relations with people external to the music business, and it makes me question why the band was pushed to the forefront. Obviously, they're absolutely fantastic and great, and I don't know anything about the background, but you know, I get a little bit skeptical when you know, particular services are involved, you know. If you want to know what I said, you're just going to have to refer to the start of the video if you haven't done so already. I don't talk about them sort of things in depth. No way. Especially when I don't understand it, right? Tim Dixon says the Doors were definitely one, if not the best group of their era. Never get tired of listening to this classic group. Tim says they were very good, but the best. Have you heard of the Beatles, Led Zeppelin, Rolling Stones? Another response is Pink Floyd, The Who, The Kinks, even Lynyrd Skynyrd or Creedence were far more better than the Doors. Highly overrated due to Jim Morrison dying young and the Club of 27 and all that rock gossiping. Morrison used to talk too much shit, like having inside the spirit of a shaman he saw dying while travelling in the desert. Too much ego was in the boy. A little bit too long-winded for me, this keyboard solo. Just had a little cheeky phone call come through. Hold on, hold on. I can already tell you, there has to be a radio edit of this one, because the solos go on for too long, and if this was as big as a hit of people saying, I doubt this is being broadcasted on a regular basis with extended solos like this. It's just not the way, is it? The song itself is about sexual climax, apparently, but the music captures the insanity, the agony, and the escape we all wanted and needed at the time through drugs, sex, and rock and roll. Robbie Krieger's guitar work is also the key in the middle, and John Denmark's drum work always moves the music forward, as in all Doors songs. Does this really go on until the end? Mm-hmm. Great revisit there to the intro riff.
The time to hesitate is through. No time to wallow in the mire.
Great dynamic on the drum kit.
Now we can only lose. And our love become a funeral pyre. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. If I was to say to you, girl, we couldn't get much higher. Come on, baby, light my fire. Come on, baby, light my fire. Try to set the night on fire. Try to set the night on fire.
One more, I'm getting another call in. Sorry about that, people. What can I say? I get a few random phone calls through the day. What can I say? It's strictly business, all right? Strictly business. Light my fire. It's a great tune. It's a great tune. There must be a radio edit to that because it's far too long, them solos. And I say that because, you know, not only does it cost to have radio time, but your general people aren't accustomed to extended instrumental sections. So that's sort of the main reason, because if you got edge, now don't get me wrong, I'm sort of mixing up the generations here, but if you've got Ed Sheeran on the radio playing a 3-minute song in perfect song format where he can drill in a hook and a lyric and have people singing that song, it would be nonsensical for a label to promote a band's song that sort of doesn't emphasize on the same hook, you know. To the same degree, it would be nonsensical to not emphasise the main part of the song, which is the come on baby, light my fire and so forth. So I'm not too big a fan of like long extended bridges personally. I did like the song. I've heard it before. I like the dynamic on the drums when the verse comes in. Of course, this is completely keyboard driven. Without the keys, the majority of the track's substance will be nada. You know, them keys really do create the sound of this track, and quite potentially the sound of the Doors, let's be fair, at this point. And it's a great line. Come on, baby, light my fire. The verses are brilliant. You know, lyrically speaking, it's nothing mind-blowing. It's not as poetic as what we've had prior, but it doesn't need to be, you know what I mean? Simplicity is sometimes the key, and in this case, most definitely. We've got Backdoor Man coming up next, track number 7. Hold on. Bada bing.